run from third here. First offering. And he waves at a curveball there. No balls and a strike.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
And there are our umpires calling balls and strikes in this one, Mr. James Kingsley.
Hey, Dero, James Kingsley's a pretty good umpire. He doesn't get too excited, keeps things under emotions. He's a pretty good ball and strike umpire.
Yeah, James Kingsley will never show you up, and he's always approachable.
And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out. High in the air out to center field. Number two is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. One left for Miami. They still trail 1-0. Now at the plate is number 39. He'll take his first hacks here.
Number 39.
Pitch on the way. Swing and a liner, but that'll land foul, strike one. Swing and a ball line hard towards short, but right there to glove it is the shortstop for the first out.
Batting nine, the pitcher.
So next to bat will be number 33. He stands in for the first time in this one. Now here's the pitch. Sends that one out of play for strike one.
Hey, when you're featuring a mid-90s fastball like this pitcher, attack with that pitch. Get ahead. Get the offense on their toes. That opens up the off-speed pitches later in the game.
Dickerson is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two. So he comes up empty in his first major league at-bat.
I know he was expecting more, but that's a win. If you could put the ball in play your first big league AB and you're able to get that adrenaline and the nerves out of you, that's a win right there.
Back up the middle, and the inning will continue as that's through for a two out hit. And there's probably no happier person in the ballpark. Joe Acker has just collected his first hit in the big leagues, and as is customary, there's the ball being sent into the dugout. Someone will tuck it away for him to put in his trophy case.
Yeah, good for him, and congratulations. Listen, he's worked his entire lifetime for this moment, and he's obviously trying to play it cool right now, but you can bet inside his head he's on top of the world.
So now to the plate, number two. He gets a shot to hit here in the inning following the two-out single.
Yeah, that hit might not amount to much, but anytime you can extend an inning and give a guy with plenty of pop a chance to swing it, the outlook of an inning changes dramatically.
Now the first pitch. And he swings through a fastball and doesn't catch up with it. It's 0-1.
No doubt this is a steal situation right here. Two outs and the leadoff hitter on first. This is the time you roll the dice and hope he gets in the scoring position where he can get a hit to bring him home.
And a pitch out. Nothing doing, though, and that's ball one. Acker is off of first with two away. Hit hard up the middle. That's through for a base hit, his second of the ball game. Long throw to third, and he's safe.
Wow, how quickly things can turn around in this game. He gets the first two outs of the inning, and he looks like he's on cruise control, thinking that he'll get out of the inning without even breaking a sweat. But then a single and a double, now he's stuck with runners on second and third.
Into the box, number one. Into right field, that's a base hit. And not in time as the run scores. Tag, and they get him at the plate as one run scores, but not the second. So it's one run on three hits, no errors, and a runner left. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three. The Farmers are out in front here, 2-0. So now to the plate, Jorge Alfaro.
The catcher.
He looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. Oh, he had him fooled there. No balls and two strikes.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Made a miss on the off-speed pitch that time. Jorge Alfaro is retired for the first out here in the bottom half of the third. At the plate now, Pablo Lopez. As he takes a called strike at the knees, it's 0-1. One out, nobody on. Swing and a miss as he pulls the top hand over. It's 0-2.
You could tell by the hitter's balance after that swing that he's seeing the ball really good. His timing is right there, and I expect him to catch something clean.
So he racks up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Pablo Lopez becomes out number two this inning. Starling Marte is in with two away here as this one swung on and missed for the first strike.
Man, that's seven straight strikes to start this inning. He's got a chance at an immaculate inning.
0-1 count. Here's the pitch. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. They'll whip this one first in time, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Marlins. They trail it here 2-0. Stepping in once again is number 25. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game.
I'm interested to see how focused their ABs will be playing with this lead. I think this needs to be a little bit of a smell blood inning. Keep the fire rolling. I know it's early, but keep the pressure going. Swinging the bat's nice.
Swing and a liner. That gets down. He's got himself a base hit. And there's probably no happier person in the ballpark. Luke has just collected his first hit in the big leagues. And as is customary, there's the ball being sent into the dugout. Someone will tuck it away for him to put in his trophy case.
Yeah, good for him and congratulations. Listen, he's worked his entire lifetime for this moment, and he's obviously trying to play it cool right now, but you can bet inside his head, he's on top of the world.
Into the box now, Max Anderson. As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Swing and a line drive, and that'll get down for a base hit. And now they'll have runners at the corners to start off the inning. And there's probably no happier person in the ballpark. Max Anderson has just collected his first hit in the big leagues. And as is customary, there's the ball being sent into the dugout. Someone will tuck it away for him to put in his trophy case.
Yeah, good for him and congratulations. Listen, he's worked his entire lifetime for this moment, and he's obviously trying to play it cool right now, but you can bet inside his head, he's on top of the world.
Stepping in now, Bryce Matthews. Line drive, base hit to right. They'll cash in here as the run is in to score from third. It's a 3-0 game. And this is pretty cool, guys. Not only is that his first big league hit, it's also his first major league RBI. Not a bad way to get your career started.
Yeah, no doubt, Matty. He took care of the two first with one swing of the bat. So congrats to him on achieving something that's really special that he's worked so very hard for. He'll never forget this moment as long as he lives.
To the plate right now, number 16. He swings and hits it foul off to the right and out of play. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. Again, another foul ball. Anderson at second. Matthews on at first with nobody out. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. And that is off the wall, but in foul territory. Foul ball.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way. And this is going to get down for extra bases as that'll get one, if not both of them, home. And the runner will score from second. And he's in safely at third as they also score a pair of runs on the play. And there's probably no happier person in the ballpark. Has just collected his first hit in the big leagues. And as is customary, there's the ball being sent into the dugout. Someone will tuck it away for him to put in his trophy case.
Yeah, good for him and congratulations. Listen, he's worked his entire lifetime for this moment, and he's obviously trying to play it cool right now, but you can bet inside his head, he's on top of the world.
Now the Marlins skipper's up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And we're going to have a pitching change as that's going to be off for his starter this afternoon. So he'll exit here this afternoon to a smattering of boos after what can be described as really a subpar performance. Eliezer Hernandez answers the call from the pen here in the fourth as they didn't get the outing they were hoping for from their starter. Standing in now, number 39, skied in the air to straightaway left. Dickerson's there, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. And a sixth run will come across on the sack fly. It's now 6-0.
Usually when you score a lot of runs in one inning, like this inning, you're doing a lot of things right. And how about this? A sack fly to drive in another run, they have to be happy with this.
Ready. Here's the first pitch. Lifted the other way down the left field line. After it is Dickerson. But he can't get there, and it bounces over the wall. It's a ground rule double. Well, that's his first major league hit. There might not be too many more to come considering he's a pitcher, but I'm sure that's still a pretty exciting moment for him.
Hey, listen, hits are hard to come by, Matt. I only had one in my entire 18-year career. One for 15, but hey, I still remember that one hit.
At the plate, Joe Acker. Swing, high drive, left field and deep. Looking up is Dickerson. And goodbye, this one ain't coming back. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left. First home run of the campaign for him as they've widened this lead to 8 now. Now, number 2. He swings and hits it foul off to the right and out of play. Two hits in two trips for him thus far. The windup and the 0-1. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Gone! Back-to-back homers. So a solo shot here to left center field, his second of the game, as they've pushed this lead up to 9 now.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
In now, number one.
Number one.
Pitch popped up. And this is going to get down. It's a foul ball. A hit and two tries for him so far. Oh, and one count and the pitch. Another one fouled off and he's quickly behind 0-2. Nothing in two count and the pitch. Swing and a long drive again. This one to deep center. Under it now is Marte to pull it in for route number two.
The batter.
Here's a look at the final line for the Marlins starting pitcher. Not the opening day he wanted to have, unfortunately.
Well, this one's really easy to dissect. Too many pitches left over the heart of the plate. Three bombs allowed in this one. He's going to have to do a better job of throwing quality pitches down the road.
And now the first pitch. Lifted down the line and left. Here's a fly ball, well hit. Marte going back to the track. On the warning track, he makes the catch. But a big inning here as 7 runs cross the plate, and this lead grows even wider. To the bottom of inning number 4 we go. The Farmers are out on top, 9-0. Now to the plate, here is Miguel Rojas. He leads off this half inning in what they hope will be a rebuttal to all those runs they just gave up.
Well, Matt, I think mentally they need to get one or two of these runs back right here. Just getting on the board after getting socked in the mouth by the opposing team can lift the team up a bit. We'll see if they can string something together.
First pitch of the AB now. And he takes a pitch right down the middle.
Hey, with this big a lead, you have to just pound the zone and force this team to get aggressive in the box.
The 0-1 pitch. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. He leaps, but he can't get it. It's down for extra bases.
Number 23, Corey Dickerson.
Stepping in now, Corey Dickerson. He grounds it sharply to third. Throw in time as he's called out on a bang bang play at first. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Adam Duvall. 1-for-1 as he reached base with a double his first time up.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
And he jumps at a changeup, a swing and a miss. Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for route number 2.
Hey, I'm not sure what he was sitting on right there. I might have been sitting on an off-speed pitch, but instead he gets the fastball. Way late, had no chance to put that ball in play.
Into the box now, Garrett Cooper.
And a swing from him yields a foul pop out of play to the right. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. He's set. Here's the 0-1. A great job of changing speeds there. It's 0-2.
Hey, make no mistake about it. This lineup's going to have to get going and get a little bit more aggressive. This guy's pounding the zone.
Here comes the nothing and two pitch. A bouncer to the left side. Right to him. Throw goes over to third. And they will not get him at first as he's able to leg out the throw.
Took a real risk by going after the lead runner there heading into third. That's always a tough call, and it's hard to fault them for being aggressive. But you hate not to get an out when the batter was giving himself up.
Into the box, Jazz Chisholm. Yes, he'll take a changeup here for strike one. 0 for 1 after a pop out in foul territory his first time through. Strike two called on the inner half. 0-2 now.
Well, you could see he's coming right at this guy, just pounding the ball in the strike zone. He certainly has the advantage now. This guy hasn't even swung the bat yet.
Skied into straightaway right. Right fielder giving chase. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Marlins strand a pair. They're looking up at a 9-0 deficit. John Curtis gets the call to pitch here, and he'll try to sort this mess out. He's going to try to at least eat a couple of innings for his guys. And now in the box, Max Anderson singled in his last at bat. He's set, and the pitch lined into right, a base hit.
No mistake what he was sitting on. Fastball, middle of the plate, kept his hands back, stayed through the baseball, and delivers a hard hit line drive.
Standing in now, Bryce Matthews. Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. And it's gone! Two-run shot to straightaway center. First home run of the campaign for him as the blowout continues.
Number 16.
At the plate now, number 16. He swings and sends it in the air to right center field. Duvall moves to his right and puts this one away in the alley for out number one.
Now that.
Next, number it'll 39. Be number 39. He hit a sack fly earlier. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. It's sharply toward third. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. And he will get in there with his first big league hit, a double. And there's probably no happier person in the ballpark. Has just collected his first hit in the big leagues. And as is customary, there's the ball being sent into the dugout. Someone will tuck it away for him to put in his trophy case.
Yeah, good for him, and congratulations. Listen, he's worked his entire lifetime for this moment, and he's obviously trying to play it cool right now, but you can bet inside his head, he's on top of the world.
At the plate. plate, number 33. Back up the middle. And that's through into center field. Base hit. The runner scores from second. And now he throws on the brakes, but he can't get back to first, and he's nailed for the second out. Big mistake there. Anthony Bass gets the call to pitch here, and he'll try to sort this mess out. He's going to try to at least eat a couple of innings for his guys.
Number 52, Anthony.
So now to the plate, Joe Acker, ripped on the ground to first. Flips it behind his back. And how about that right out of the bullpen? A ground ball on one pitch and the inning is over. So they pick up three runs on four base hits. No errors and no one left on base. Home half of the fifth coming up. Nebraska is on top here, 12-0. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the commercial break, I had a chance to catch up with manager Don Mattingly about the Marlins' offensive production. And one thing he stressed to me was the need for them to have better at-bats when they've got runners on base. They've had their opportunities with runners in scoring position, but still have zero hits to show for it in those situations. He said repeatedly not coming through with a big hit can wear on you as a team, but in this sport, you have to dwell on the positives. He's confident they'll find a way to break through sooner or later.
All right, thanks, Heidi. Into the box, Brian Anderson. He leads off in the bottom of the fifth as they look to break through on the scoreboard for the first time in this one.
Yeah, no doubt about it. You can tell in between innings the veterans in that dugout going up and down the line, trying to keep this lineup from getting super frustrated. They just have to find a way to piece it together, maybe pass the baton, get some wheels in motion, maybe get aggressive on the base pass if they can get somebody on.
Behind 0-2 now. Fouled off. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down.
I always like watching pitchers that attack with their fastballs until there's a reason to start mixing it up. He hasn't needed many of his secondary pitches so far in this one, and there was another good fastball for a strikeout there.
Stepping in now, Jorge Alfaro. As he swings and misses at a first pitch fastball, 0-1. No runs, two hits, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Long run for the right fielder, and he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out. John Birdie will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number five, John.
Now the first pitch. Below the zone, a swing and a miss.
Not an easy thing to do to fill up the strike zone and be successful doing it. How about this guy so far in this one? 100% of his first pitches have been for strikes. Well, that's what wheels can do for you, D-Row. You can see this right here on this replay. He just simply outruns the white rabbit. He just outruns the baseball.
Yeah, it's beautiful to watch. You know why? Because this is the one tool you can't teach. You can take countless ground balls. You can hit till your hands bleed. But if you got no wheels, newsflash, you got no wheels.
0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Behind 0-2 now. Birdie leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. And he fouls this one off. To short, hit hard. Reined in. Low in time and the side is retired. Marlins lead one. Just about given up for dead. It's 12-0. Adam Simber gets the call to pitch here, and he'll try to sort this mess out. He's going to try to at least eat a couple of innings for his guys. Number two stands in looking for home run number three right here, as you see what he's done so far in this one.
Number
Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. Line toward the alley in left center. And this is going to find the alley as he might have himself his second double of the ballgame. And he will pull into second with a leadoff double.
Now batting.
He just tattoos this ball right here. Tried to sneak a fastball in on him? No way. Drives it to deep left center field gap, and that was a nice job to get the barrel around in time to score that baby up.
Into the box now, number one. Now a ball hit in the air to straightaway left. This is carrying well out of here. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left. First home run of the campaign for him as they just continue to pour it on here. Now number 25, and he's first pitch swinging here as he lines this one into left field for a base hit.
Loud noises right here, fellas. Hey, he's gonna have to mix it up a little bit more because they are on his stuff.
Max Anderson.
In now, Max Anderson. He swings and sends a bullet to right field. But he will come on strong out there in right and pull this one down for the first down.
The batter number 14, second baseman.
Ready to take his hacks again, Bryce Matthews. Blasted a two-run homer in his last at-bat. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Donnie extends nicely, and this ball's driven to right field and deep. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run. So a two-run homer down the line in right field, his second home run of the game, as this lead got even wider.
When this one left the bat, I thought it was going to be an easy out to right, but it just kept carrying and carrying, and the right fielder gave it a great effort and almost brought it back, but no dice.
Richard Blyer gets the call to pitch here, and he'll try to sort this mess out. He's going to try to at least eat a couple of innings for his guys.
Richard Blyer.
At the plate, number 16. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Hit in the air out to right. Duvall is back in plenty of time to put this away, however, and there are two gone.
The bat, number 39.
So next to hit is number 39. He doubled earlier in the game, 1-for-2 to this point. Now here's the first offering. Grounded weakly down the line toward third.
Foul.
This gets foul. It's 0-1. Now here's the pitch. Lifted down the line in left. A pause and the 0-2. Lifted into center field. Marte is under it. And that ends the inning. So four runs in the inning, and they come on the strength of the two big flies. 2, 3, and 4 due up in the home half of the sixth. Nebraska is out in front, 16-0.
Leading off for the Marlins, the shortstop, Peter Rojas.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Hit high and deep out to left center field. A ball that's carrying. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
Talk about starting off the inning with a bang. Goodness. When this thing left the bat, I thought it was out of here. And I think he might have too. Only made it to the warning track, but he glides into second base with a leadoff double.
So now to the plate, Corey Dickerson, as he'll try to hold back on the swing, but he went around for the first strike. 0 for 2 for him to this point. And Dickerson behind 0-2 now. Out in front of that one, but he stays alive and will do it again on 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Grounder down the line at third, but a foul ball, and the count holds at 0-2.
Wow, this guy has been on top of it today, pushing the throttle and pulling it when he needs to.
Rojas leads off second with nobody out. Hit in the air to shallow center. Likely too shallow to advance here, as that's taken by the center fielder.
The right fielder,
at plate now is Adam Duvall. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
Scooped up. Throw gets him. Two down. Next, it'll be Garrett Cooper. He reached on a fielder's choice previously.
Cooper.
From the stretch, here's the pitch, and it's fouled away.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
I got the count.
Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control. 0-2. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. One left for Miami. Still 16-0. So here now is the pitcher, number 33, 2 for 3 with a double on his line so far. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Opposite field to left. But he'll hardly need to move out there in left, as this is hauled in for the first out.
Now jumped batting. All over right that field. First pitch of the inning, and he didn't miss it. After. Just wasn't able to steer it in a direction that resulted in a leadoff hit.
Standing in now, Joe Acker. This is in the air out to straightaway center. After it is Marte. He gets there, and that's the second out. And stepping in, number 2. Great game for him so far. 4 hits, including a couple of home runs. Here's the first pitch to him. Line shot to second, but it's caught, and the side is retired. Ready Pitching now for the Marlins, Jazz Chisholm flew out last time up.
The second baseman.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. Watches a fastball right there for strike one.
Hey, it's really hard to pitch a gem, and what helps? This guy's
high fly ball out to deep right field. And a scaling attempt at the wall, but it'll be in vain because this ball is gone. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. First home run of the campaign for him, but that'll do little more than make a dent in this big deficit.
What a great feeling right there as he circles the pillows, finally able to get this offense potentially going with one swing of the bat, being shut out all game, but not anymore.
Out of the dugout, making the slow trek to the mound, and he's going to make a move as that's going to be all for his starter this afternoon. Tired a bit as he reached the seventh, but he's got a shot at the victory if his bullpen can help him out. At the plate now, Brian Anderson. And on the first pitch, he grounds foul. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Behind 0-2 now. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Another 0-2 coming. Fouled away. The 0-2 once more. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
Now batting, the catcher, Jorge Alfaro.
Stepping in now, Jorge Alfaro. As he'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half, it's 0-1. Bases are empty, one man out. Swing and a miss, and he's in control, 0-2. And he strikes him out as well. So two punch outs to begin the outing out of the pen. Jesus Aguilar will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. First pitch coming, here it is. There's a fastball right down Broadway, taken for a strike. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a miss as he pulls the top hand over. It's 0-2.
Well, he's just two outs into his.
We'll have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. But not before they answer back here with a solo home run. We'll march on to the eighth. Nebraska is out in front here, 16-1. Leamy Garcia comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one.
Jimmy Garcia.
now at the plate, number one. He went deep earlier, and he's 2-for-4 to this point.
Number one.
He's set. Here it comes. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Hard hit ball to second. He's got it. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. Hitter to try and make an impact with one away. From the stretch, fouled off. Garcia typically throws a lot of strikes coming in out of the bullpen, resulting in low walk totals, although he has been snake bitten by the home run ball at times in the past.
One of the keys for this guy, Matt, is not being afraid to attack the strike zone. With that said, he is prone to giving up the home runs. I think one of the causes of that, Matty B, he leaves them.
Hit high and deep to left field. Dickerson going back. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Next to hit is Max Anderson. These two have not faced each other at the major league level. First pitch coming. Here it is. No balls and a strike to count. With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, Peter.
And we'll just leave it there as they make the play to end the inning. Number 11 will stay in the ball game as he'll take over at first base.
Number 11.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go. Coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Starling Marte. Into the ball game now as he'll take over out in left field.
Your attention, please. Now playing left field. Number 29. There. Check.
First offering on its way. That's in there. And he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
Whoo, that was some gas. Triple digits on the radar gun.
Fastball called, strike 3, and there's the first out of the inning. Now to the plate, Miguel Rojas. He's roped a couple of doubles in 3 trips to this point. Here's the first pitch. Popped him up. And he'll put this one away in foul territory for the second out.
The left fielder, number 23.
Ready now is Corey Dickerson. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. First offering. Line drive, base hit. Around first, digging for 2. And big trouble as this gets to the wall now.
As we take a look at the replay here, you can see that it was a hanging changeup. Nice job of staying back on it, and he's able to tattoo it for a double. And you know, if that pitch would have supplied more velocity, it might have been out of here. He hit it right on the screws.
Frank enters here looking to get the final out before the ninth inning. Now, Adam Duvall, as he will take a look at strike one on a fastball right down the pipe. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. And he fouls this one off. The 0-2 delivery. Got him looking, and that ends the inning. So they can't make anything out of the two-out double. Back with more of this Thursday afternoon business person special following this. New inning set to get underway, and next will be the speed threat, Bryce Matthews.
Ah, man, he's making a lot of noise in this one. He's feeling really locked in at the plate right now. We used to have a saying in the dugout, anybody could get two. There ain't too many guys hitting north of two bombs in the game in the big leagues.
Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Up next, number 16. He has no prior history against this pitcher. Number 31 steps into the on-deck circle now, looking to start something here with one gone in the inning. First pitch of the AB now. Now a big fastball, and he's well behind it with the swing. Grounded back up the middle, and that is through into center field for a one-out single. And there's probably no happier person in the ballpark. Has just collected his first hit in the big leagues. And as is customary, there's the ball being sent into the dugout. Someone will tuck it away for him to put in his trophy case.
Yeah, good for him, and congratulations. Listen, he's worked his entire lifetime for this moment, and he's obviously trying to play it cool right now, but you can bet inside his head, he's on top of the world.
Plate, Cam Chick, and he's a bit tardy there on the first pitch fastball. It's nothing and one. High in the air down the right field line. Long run for the right fielder, and he makes the catch in the corner. Now to the plate, the pitcher. Frank, number 10, will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Pinch hitting, number 10.
Here's the first pitch to him. Oh, and he goes the other way, and he drives it out to deep right center field. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. So it's a two-run shot to right center. First home run of the campaign for him as the blowout continues. now, Joe Acker, as he'll send a ground ball down to third. Over to first, and that retires the side. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run home run. Last chance coming up here for the Marlins. And the visitors are out in front here, 18-1. Number 31 will stay in the ball game as he'll likely do the catching from here out. Number 40 is ready, and he'll take the ball from the manager. Now into the box is Garrett Cooper, starting things for his side in the ninth as they face the improbable odds of trying to come back in this one.
Yeah, not a lot of hope for them at this point. These guys know these bats still count, at least for their own stats. You can't mill in your chances as a professional.
First pitch on its way. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Center fielder giving chase. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. Up next from Miami, Jazz Chisholm. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far.
Yeah, man, this guy's been as advertised. We heard that if this guy could get his foot down, he could get wood on a bullet. That last pitch and that last AB, that was triple digits, Matty V, and he still turned it around.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. He pulls this one high and deep to right center field. And that's a home run into the top tank. Solo shot to right center, his second of the game, but they're going to need a few more here as they're still well behind. Nine home runs. Hero Dan, when's the last time you saw a power performance like this from two competing teams?
Matty V, I can't ever recall nine home runs in a game, Hero. This has been a case of bad pitching, good hitting, and guys getting pitches to hit and not missing.
Yeah, Dan, we got to love our both offenses right now. I don't think if you paid the price of admission for a ticket in the last decade, you're seeing a combined nine home runs hit.
Now got it. Get through.
Marlins down to their final out now. And up next will be the big catcher, Jorge Alfaro. First offering on its way.
Ball one, no strike.
Two out, nobody on. Shot toward second. And he'll put this one away. And with that, the ball game is over.
Well, that wasn't exactly a nail biter. But it's always nice when you can get an offensive explosion like that and save your closer for another day. A comfortable victory.
18-2, the final tally today. The Farmers claim victory by plating a total of 18 runs. Number 33 gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. Pablo Lopez struggled and gets the loss after giving up 6 earned. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com. Clean up base. Got a cardboard if you got it. Going live, good at the show. Figure the first. Two-seam ain't enough. Four-tie team is us. Man, on first, on second, on third. I'm gonna have to clean it up. I done went yard. They ball gone. The alien beamed it up. Man, contract, they want me back. I'm gonna have to clean it up. Like Ben Waywall, really feel fine. Worry about y'all, it's just my time. I got the green right, that's the green light. That's just my sign.
Time of the ball game. 4 hours and 3 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you of